Okay, here's something you probably need on most websites you're building: file upload. You have a website where you get some files from your users and you want to store them on one of their servers. So for example, I recently, as a little fun side project, built my own AI-powered headshot generator. And of course, there I want to allow users to upload files so that they can then use them to generate headshots of themselves with help of AI. Now, this or many other apps are examples where you need file upload, and file upload can be daunting if you don't have a lot of experience with it. You might be aware of packages like Malter, which you can use with node.js or Bun to handle files that are submitted as part of multi-part forms on your server so that you can store them on your file system. But the truth is that very often you don't want to do that. You don't want to store files selected by your users on your servers. Sure, there are apps where you might want to do that because you need to parse or handle them, but in many cases you just want to store them in some cloud storage. So not necessarily on your server, not necessarily on the VPS that's hosting your website. So one popular cloud storage, of course, is Amazon S3. Amazon S3 is a service by AWS which allows you to just drop all kinds of files into one large bucket, one large hard drive, you could say, that's hosted on AWS servers. And you can do that via an API from your computer, from your server, from anywhere you want. Now, S3 is great, but it's also not the cheapest service, which is why I personally like Cloudflare R2 quite a bit. And just to be very clear, this is not a sponsored video. This is just a service I'm using a lot. Cloudflare R2 is also a cloud file storage, and it's S3 compatible, which means you can use the official S3 SDK, for example, also with Cloudflare, and that's kind of what we'll do in this video. So for this little demo, for this little tutorial here, I built a very basic website with React and React Router, and you find it attached both the starting state and the finish state once the upload is implemented. And in this app, I just got two routes, upload and uploaded files, and I got some dummy files here, which aren't actually files that have been uploaded yet because I haven't added that functionality yet. Instead, in my backend, which is just a vanilla Bun app in this case, so using a JavaScript with Bun. In that backend, I got a couple of routes, we'll get back to those. There, I'm using Bun's built-in SQLite support. I talked about that in a past video, which allows me to set up a SQLite database, which is just a SQL database living in a file in your project, on your system, on your VPS, wherever you're running this app, which is amazing. And there, I got a dummy uploads table, which for the moment just stores some file name and file size. And then I'm inserting some dummy data there, but that will of course change. And then on the upload page here, as you can see, we got a little drag and drop area, and in there I can drop files. I see them here, and in the future I want to be able to upload them. Right now when I click upload, we do go to that uploaded files folder, and technically the file does show up here, but only because I added in the database in my backend code through that post-upload route there. I'm extracting the file name and file size of the file that was dropped into that drag-and-drop area, and I store that in the database, but I don't actually store the file, and that's what we will change, of course. Now, in Cloudflare, in my account here, I'll start by creating a new bucket, which is the thing where you drop your files into, and I'll name it File Upload Demo. Name is up to you. Location automatic is okay for me here, and the default storage class is okay too, so I'll just create that bucket here. And here it is. Now I could drop files into that bucket and upload them like this, but of course that's not the idea here. So I'll get rid of that file. Instead, we want to upload from our app. And here we got two main ways of doing that. The first approach would be to kind of accept that file on our backend, in our backend routes, and then forward it to Cloudflare. We could do that. We could be using packages like Malter to help with that. We could try all kinds of things there. That would be one way. And we might want to do that if we first need to process that file. But even in those cases, we might also not want to do that and instead directly upload it and then kick off some background job that processes the file. Anyways, it's not what we will do here, because the second approach is actually the one that's often much better. We want to directly upload from the client, from the front end, to Cloudflare. However, we can't just expose a direct link to this Cloudflare bucket because this bucket should stay protected. We don't want to create a public bucket. We could, by the way, if you would have a use case where this should truly be open to everyone, but I don't want that here. It should be a closed private bucket, and nonetheless, we want to allow users of our app to upload to that bucket. How do we do that? The answer is pre-signed URLs. A pre-signed URL is simply a temporarily active URL that grants the user of that URL certain rights, like, for example, being able to use that URL to upload a file to the destination of that URL, to this bucket. So we want to create such a pre-signed URL to this bucket, which is valid for, let's say, 5 minutes, 1 minute, anything like that. And we want to do that. We want to generate that URL right at the point of time where a user clicks this upload files button. That's when we want to create that pre-signed URL. Then we want to use that pre-signed URL and we want to use it to upload this file directly from inside the browser, from inside the React application, with help of that pre-signed URL to Cloudflare. That's what we want to do. Now, how do we do that? Well, it's actually pretty simple because Bun, which I'm using here, has built-in S3 support. It has a built-in S3 client. Alternatively, we could use the Amazon, the AWS S3 SDK, the official S3 SDK. It's available for all kinds of programming languages. And since R2 is compatible with S3, we could use that as well. But since I'm using Bun already, it's even easier to use that. So what I'll do here is I'll use a little bit of AI. I'll copy this page, this documentation. I'll go back to my project here and I'll add a R2TS file in my backend folder, in the source folder. And I want to say, I want to support file uploads via pre-signed URLs in the web app I'm building. We'll use Bun's built-in S3 client for that. Here's its documentation. And then I like to do these XML tags, paste that copied documentation from the Bun website into those tags. And then at the end, I'll say, add the logic for creating pre-signed upload and download URLs into this R2 file we created. And now thanks to that documentation I passed in here, the AI should be able to do that. So I'll just enter and let it do its thing. That's not all we need to do, but it's a first important step. Because whilst the AI is working here, we can already continue. Because the next step is that in index.ts, in this post upload route, I no longer just want to store that dummy metadata here in my database. Instead, I want to create such a pre-signed URL with help of that logic that's currently being written by AI and send that back to the client, to the React application, so that in there, via the browser, via browser APIs, we can upload the file directly to R2. So now that the AI is done, we can take a look at the R2TS file and we see we need some access credentials here. We need these credentials in order to be able to create these pre-signed URLs, which makes sense because not everybody should be able to create pre-signed upload or download URLs to our bucket because that would essentially make the bucket publicly available if everybody could be doing that. So we need an access key ID, a secret access key, and of course the bucket and endpoint. So what I'll do here, I'll add a new .env file in my backend folder and set up an R2 bucket, R2 endpoint, R2 access key ID, and R2 secret access key. And in this R2TS file that was created by AI, I'll use these here, R2 access key, R2 secret access key, R2 bucket, and R2 endpoint. Now, how do I get the values for these env vars? Well, back in Cloudflare, there, in your R2 object storage overview, you get these account details. And there you can manage your API token. So I'll do that and create a new account API token. And I'll name it file upload demo. It should be read and write because I want to support both uploading and downloading. And I'll apply it to a specific bucket, to this file upload demo bucket, and click create account API token. Now this will give me some values, amongst them an access key ID and a secret access key. So the access key ID is what I use for the R2 access key ID. The secret access key is what I use for the R2 secret access key. This endpoint is what I use for endpoint. And for the bucket, remember my bucket name is file upload demo. So I'll just copy that and use that here. And these are my env vars. So with that, we'll be able to initialize this R2 client. And then in there, we got functions written by AI, hopefully they will work, that will actually create these pre-signed upload URLs or download URLs, which would allow us to interact with R2. And then it looks like, because it's AI, it created a bunch of other stuff as well. Also a function for generating a file key, because that's essentially the file name that will be used for the file on R2. And the extension was missing for me here. Great, so now we got this. Now I'll again use AI, just because that allows me to continue explaining while it's working for me, to tell it that it should now use this R2 functionality in that backend root file with all these routes to actually create a pre-signed upload URL, which is valid for 5 minutes, for the file information that is sent. So I'll hit enter, and that should now hopefully use that newly created function to create such a pre-signed upload URL and send it back to the frontend. So here we go. It did that. Reminds me to set up the env variables, which I already did. And I will now tell it to also add the functionality on the front end to use that received upload URL to initiate and perform that upload. So I'll just tell the AI to go to the front end, make sure all required information is sent to the back end, so all the information we need here, and then that it should upload via XHR, not via the fetch API, because XHR, this old school way of sending HTTP requests from the front end, allows us to track progress. And then I want to show a nice overlay with a progress bar as we upload files in parallel. That's the idea. And what this will now do is that we'll handle that request that's coming from the front end to create that pre-sent upload URL, and then hopefully upload from the frontend to our Cloudflare bucket directly without really touching our server, except for getting those pre-signed URLs. That's done by our server, of course. So now it's done. I'll restart my backend server to make sure all changes are picked up, and I'll drop new files in there, click upload files, and it fails. And it fails with some permission errors, some course-related permission errors. And the reason for that is that we got our pre-signed URL, here it is, but Cloudflare has a little security mechanism or some control mechanisms in place to not allow every application to use these pre-signed URLs to upload. Though I will say only the browser really respects that security mechanism, because we're talking about course here. On our Cloudflare R2 bucket, we need to add a course policy to allow our application, which of course is hosted on a different domain than the Cloudflare bucket, to communicate with that bucket, to send a request. So I'll add a course policy here. And by default, we get this one, which would allow an application running on localhost 3000 to get files. But I have an application running on localhost 5173, and I also want to be able to put files, which is the HTTP method that's used for uploading. Now, you might say, wait, isn't it post? I mean, it's a post route here. Yes, but that's the route on our backend for getting the pre-signed URL. The actual upload request from the frontend using that pre-signed URL, that will be a put request. You can see that here in that frontend code. So I want to allow put requests, and I'll also add some allowed headers. And to make things easy here, I'll allow all headers and save that. Now with this policy in place, if I reload my application here, paste this in here and click upload, now you see it's uploaded. Now I'm forwarded. Now my files are here. And I got a lot of files here because I'm still storing them in the database as the pre-signed URLs are being created, not as the upload completes. And that's something we'll fix soon. Before we do that though, let's take a look at our Cloudflare storage, refresh this page, and you see, got an uploads folder in there, and in there, got my files. Here I am. Lovely. Okay, so there's one last thing I want to do here, because I mentioned that one problem is that in my application, I'm storing information about my files in the database whenever I create that pre-signed URL. And I instead want to store information only once I know that the upload succeeded. Then I also actually want to store the R2 key, so the actual identifier of the file on R2, so that we could use that in the future for retrieving that file. I'll again do that with help of AI here. And here I'm telling the AI that I don't just want to have a route for creating the pre-signed upload URLs, but that I also want to register successful uploads with a new route that must be added, a post upload success route. And this route should be triggered from the front end. Once an upload did succeed, I need the R2 key in there. Therefore, of course, my DBTS file also must be updated, because currently in there, I'm creating a table that only stores file name and file size. I also want to store the R2 key, so I need to update that. I'll need to recreate my database then. And of course, the front end code should should be updated as well to make sure that we do actually send all that data to the backend. And then we'll have a nice flow where we get the pre-sent upload URL, where we then used it in the browser to send the file to the bucket, and where we then send the success message back to our own server so that there we can store the necessary information in our database. And that's then a very nice flow for uploading files and for being aware of all the file uploads, which of course is also important. So now that the AI finished, the dbts file is much simpler because now in there we just create that table with the r2 key field in it. r2ts didn't change, and index.ts did change. There we now also got to upload success post route in addition to the old upload post route, which still is responsible for generating the pre-signed URLs, but upload success now actually expects a request that contains the file name, file size, and R2 key, and then we store that information in our database here. And actually, I don't need created at here because the database will insert that automatically due to how it's set up. So let's remove that. And here. Now on the front end, we still have that entire upload logic where we also track the progress and so on. But if we were successful, we sent that request to the backend to upload success. We sent all that information about the file, including that R2 key that was used for uploading, to our backend. And with that, I should only need to delete that database to get rid of all the old data, restart my backend server. And now on uploaded files, I get nothing yet. If I go to upload though, I can drop my files in there, click upload files, and they're stored here. Now I see them here. And if I reload this uploaded files page, I still see that data here because it was stored in my database. And that's how you could implement upload with help of Cloudflare R2 or S3 without uploading the files to your server by instead using such pre-signed upload URLs to directly upload them to the cloud server. Of course, one important note is that very often, typically, you would have this entire logic behind a sign up so that not every unauthenticated user can start uploading to your bucket. But for the purpose of keeping this demo simple, I just focused on the upload part here. You find all the code below, and definitely let me know what you think of this video and this approach, and I hope this was helpful.